I'm so glad to be here at this wonderful, wonderful bookstore to talk about my new book, number 9 in Inspection Theory, Blue Dragon, White Tiger. Sorry, I don't know how to pronounce that in French. This is a different book for me, and also a difficult one for me, because one of the original idea came to me actually in the talk with my American friends in China. You know, they live there, and they say, no, you cannot write this book, because if you do, all the detail in the book are so strange, your publisher will not accept it. Well, that's a challenge, right? And there's another reason I wanted to write about this book, because it's also from another talk with my friends in China. Now this time, Chinese friend. They say, how can your Inspector Chen have done so many anti-corruption cases without getting into trouble? Now he has a point, right? It's, you know, for people like Inspector Chen are getting fewer and fewer in China, and it's true, they almost always getting big trouble. So I thought, yeah, I should write a book to put him, you know, in trouble. And finally, there's another thing. You know, this book is based on Bolshevik scandal. And that's a huge event in China, because at one time, Bolshevik was seen as a possible candidate for the number one party position in China. Very ambitious man and very powerful. And Bolshevik happened to be my schoolmate in Beijing. So I even wrote a short article about this in New York Times, saying, you know, the reality is stranger than my fiction. That's true. You know, I remember when I studied in Beijing, one thing between me and Bolshevik, we play ping pong together. And he borrowed my ping pong racket without ever returning it to me. Now, it might be something very small in itself, but I know these people, you know, these red princes. They simply take things for granted. Whatever you have, whatever I like, it's mine. So it's, that can also explain why Bolshevik, like, you know, murder people, kill so many people, took so much money into the pact, because, you know, the country is something just they take for granted as theirs. So I really want to try in this book to explore not just about Bolshevik himself or his wife, you know, or people following him. I try to explore, we have to do something about the system. Without that, people like Bolshevik will come again and again in the Chinese life. So I'm so glad, you know, actually this book coming out in French first. And again, I want to thank, you know, my French publisher for their really wonderful work. And I hope you like all of them. But I don't want to say too much about the weird details, because as I mentioned, sometimes things can be even stranger than in my imagination. Thank you.